I'm going to share with you in this video a plugin that is going to save your butt. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies, and I have got something to share with you that I came across, and I was just thinking, oh my gosh, why did I not know of this before? This is going to help so many people. I've got to kind of help these guys and get the word out there. It's a free plugin, though, so even if I get the word out there, it's not going to really benefit these guys and put any money in their pockets, but I found a free plugin called WP Rollback, and I'm going to show you what this thing does and when you want to use this thing. You definitely want to make a note of this plugin. It's right here. It is free. It's called WP Rollback, and it does that very thing. It allows you to roll back a plugin that you may have updated and it broke your site, a theme that you may have updated and it broke your site. Now, there are some limitations that I'm going to explain just so you understand how this works, but I'm going to give you two real-world examples of this. One of the page builders I like, and I've even made this criticism to them and publicly about it. I do love the page builder. It's called Elementor, and Elementor, unfortunately, they make these ambitious moves in developing their plugin, and what happens sometimes is when they release a plugin, it may have a bug or two and cause a lot of problems for people that clicked on the update button. I know me, I love to keep things updated, and sometimes you're really rolling the dice, and so there have been many folks that have gone and clicked on the update button. Now their website doesn't work and they're like, oh man, what do I do now? How do I get the old version? And how do I, if I can get the old version, how do I install the old version and all these types of things? That's a perfect example. Another perfect example is the learning management system that I use and I like to recommend. It's called Lifter LMS, and they have had this problem where they've issued out an update and it did cause some problems. And it just happens. There's nothing wrong with either of these companies. It just happens sometimes. And another one is WooCommerce. Now, WooCommerce just released a big, massive update, WooCommerce 3.0. They changed a lot of things. And so if you're familiar with WooCommerce, it has all these extensions. And the problem was these extensions were not WooCommerce 3.0 ready. So when you updated WooCommerce, you'd find all these extensions that gave you this functionality. None of it worked anymore because you didn't have updates for those. Where that really is a problem is if you're downloading these WooCommerce extensions just on some sites that give it away for free and you didn't really buy it, and then you don't have access to updates, you're really in a tight spot. And so it's actually funny. You'll see if you come to this page right here, depending on when you come, you scroll down and read the reviews, it's person after person that installed this WooCommerce update and said, oh my gosh, this plugin saved me. This plugin saved me. So if you have downloaded a plugin and you've updated it and it's caused you a problem, here is how you will fix it. So what you want to do is log into the back end of your WordPress website, go to plugins, go to add new, and then do a quick search for WP Rollback. And here it is. You can see I have already installed it. It's already on 20,000 websites and there's 58 reviews. If you do use this and it saves you, definitely leave these guys a review. As a matter of fact, I will be leaving these guys a review today. So let me tell you some of the limitations of this. Let me actually just show you how it works. Once you install and activate it, when you're looking at your themes or plugins, you will see this option for each. Not all of them, but I'll tell you the distinction. You'll see this option that says rollback, and then when you click on it, it will allow you to choose a prior version, and I'll demonstrate that in this video. Now, here's the only limitation. This only works with themes and plugins that you can download in the WordPress repository. And what that means is if you can download it on wordpress.org, this will allow you to roll it back. If you downloaded something on ThemeForest or some third-party website, it's just not going to work with that because it has no way of rolling it back because it doesn't work the way that it works when it's on WordPress.org. Perfect example. Everything I have right here, was installed on WordPress.org. But say I had the paid version of Beaver Builder. It's not going to be able to roll those back. If you had the free version of Beaver Builder, you would be able to because that's available at WordPress.org. Also, if you use any of the products from Thrive Themes, none of those you'll be able to roll back because they are not available on WordPress.org. So that's the only distinction or limitation. So here is Elementor, and I'm going to go ahead and click on this rollback option, and here it is. Here's all the prior versions. I can jump back to any version I felt like going back to. So if I upgraded to 1.4.2, and it's incredibly stable, by the way, I wouldn't do this only for this demonstration, but if I wanted to roll back to this prior one, 1.4.1, I would just click on that box. I would scroll down, I would click on rollback, and right here, it's going to just give me like a little bit of a confirmation and some information. And whenever you're doing anything like this, it's always a good idea to have a backup. And I've got videos on how to make a backup. It's not going to cost you anything. So go ahead and then click on that rollback option right there. And it's going to go ahead and do its magic. Now, here is the thing. You can do this manually if you wanted to. It would involve going to find the prior version, downloading it to your computer, logging into your website, deactivating the plugin, deleting the plugin, and then you're going to have to upload this older version and activate it and then hope everything just works out right. So this eliminates all of that, but usually all of that's actually pretty easy. The hardest part for someone new to WordPress is, where do I even find this prior old version? It's not really that obvious. So anyways, it already went ahead and did that. I just need to click on activate, and then you're going to see I have this prior version. And of course, it's telling me there is an updated version to the Elementor because I just rolled it back a little bit. So anyways, you can download prior versions of plugins. They keep tweaking the way this layout here works. So if you went to the plugin page here on WordPress.org, might be under advanced view or something like that. There is an option to download the prior, here it is, previous version, and then here's the prior versions for whatever plugin might be in there. You can download it. That's how you get it, but it's not so obvious when you come here. Most people don't even know you could do that anyway. So this is just a real easy way. It'll cover your butt. If you click on update or you have some system in place that's automatically updating your plugins, which is a good thing, but sometimes a developer might not have tested their plugin or theme enough and you run into these problems. So just keep in mind the limitations. It's only for WordPress.org plugins and themes. If you do use this and it covers your butt, I would go ahead and go to the plugin page right there and leave them a 5-star review to thank them for doing that. But this is by far the easiest way for anybody new to WordPress or even been around for a while to easily roll back any plugin or theme after an update that has broken their website. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.